now someone who's been one of our greatest performers and artists for many years, going back almost 20. And he and his band are just awesome, phenomenal. And please make welcome to the stage Peter Rowan and friends.
Holy Ghost. thank you so much. Really glad to be here. And that is a special sound right there. Sound of space eating itself. Sounds good. Interesting way to start the evening, and glad you all been enjoying the show. Jeff Mosier, how about Jeff? Brother Jeff. And I just want to pass the word, Jeff, if you're around here later on, we'll come up and pick one with us, you'd be welcome too. There's a lot of smoky substances up here, and I don't know, it smells like they're burning the New York Times in disgust. Hey, but I'm a Republican, but never mind, I'm prejudiced. It was a joke I heard on TV, never mind. Fake news, yeah. So we want to play you Bill Monroe song Down Our Way. And this is one of Bill's great love songs to his sweetheart, Bessie Lee Maudlin. And it's interesting that the father of bluegrass would have a longtime mistress named Maudlin. But hey, that's just a thought, never mind. How many know what Maudlin means? That's not a lot of people that know what Maudlin means. Never mind, won't use that line again. Until I play a university or somewhere. Google it. We'll have to Google it. Can't you hear me calling? Thank you. Thank you. Melancholy, too, is another one. Who knows what melancholy means? Hey, we're getting there. We're getting there. Yes. The backlights. They're blazing in, they're blazing behind us, the backlights. Those are our auras, sweetheart. I didn't know. I'm just kidding. But we have the backlights on. Can we darken the stage in the back here? Are we good? Okay, lights full on the audience. No, I'm just... Jimmy Rogers tune in the key of C. This is where the blue yodel came from. Did I say blue yodel? I meant to say blue yodel. And melancholy. I guess music is the great cure for melancholy. And if it's a little maudlin, that's just the bluegrass part of it, you know. What's wrong with me today? Say maudlin. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, I'm going to California where they sleep out every night. I'm going to California where they sleep out every night. Sure don't treat me right. Yodely. Well, I'm going where the water tastes like cherry wine. I'm going where the water tastes like cherry wine. Oh, the Georgia water tastes just like
Thank you.
session on the Stanley Brothers. He used to play right here in this park, and they worked for, what was the name of the company they were sponsored by?
Jim Walters Homes. They were
pretty fast. Homes. Jim Walters. He's probably still around. He probably lives here on the campground for all I know. These are probably all Jim Walters homes, and we are all items in Jim Walters' dream, as told by the Stanley Brothers. To Bill Monroe. In the session that Bill Monroe produced for the Stanley Brothers, did this song here. to be a little bit shaded, and the sun being so bright all night long like it is here. Yeah. Let's have let me introduce you to our Ladobro here, Mr. Michael Butcher. And I'm going to brag on him and his brother Gabe, who plays in the, I don't want to say Village People, it's just something, that's not right, he plays in the Brunch Brothers. There's just weird things coming from the audience tonight. It's just throwing me way out of line here. So Gabe produced Sarah Watkins' record, too. And so they're a little family history here. There's a lot of interweaving going on. And right here, playing the mandolins, one of our best bluegrass mandolin singers here, Mr. Chris Henry. And back on the bass is, we call him the mast of the ship. Got to fill the sail. He keeps the mast steady. Mr. Paul Knight on the bass, making welcome to you. And back here on the percussion, on the banjo with no neck. He was here last year with us, and so much fun to play with him. From Oklahoma, he's from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Please make him welcome, Mr. Jamie Oldacre. I love that banjo he's playing right there. You know, somebody once said, the banjo, you can't beat it with a stick. Oh, but you can. And we'd like to give a shout out to Chris's band who's here tonight, I do believe. Yeah. What's their names?
Malia, Fatana, Jessica, Corey Walker, Brian McDowell. We've just been having a lovely time at the park, so thank you.
I'm glad you all came. Thank you for being here with us tonight. From the great state of West Virginia, it's not far from Washington, D.C., but it's a million miles from certain things and too close for others, but then again, I'm prejudiced. So, playing the fiddle, please make him welcome for this about third or fourth time here, Mr. Blaine Sprouse from West Virginia.
I guess it was Bob Wills made this famous.
Yeah.
And one of my favorite fiddlers of all time, you probably have heard of him, Chubby Wise. Anybody heard of Chubby Wise down here in Florida?
He's a Florida fiddler.
Yes, sir. No, we're going to do that other one. One called The Maiden's Prayer. Thank you.
Chris Henry here is going to sing a number, and it's about a man gone bad, but hey, haven't we all seen that? What's this number you have picked out there, Christopher?
Well, it was one of the few rare bluegrass songs to make it on a mainstream commercial, and it was on a MasterCard commercial about 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 20 years ago. I'm dating myself, but I am single. This is called I Laid Around and Played Around in This Old Town Too Long.
Thank you for sharing.
You're contagious.
Banjer? I never thought I'd see a banjer. Reverend Jeff. told you, welcome to our stage. Our temporary platform of uninhibited musical thingamajig. Thingamajig, right? Well, now as a bluegrass boy, playing with the father of bluegrass, Mr. Bill Monroe, we used to play the Grand Ole Opry on a Saturday night and climb aboard the old bus we called the Bluegrass Breakdown for some obvious reasons. And we would ride all night up to Bean Blossom, Indiana from Nashville, Tennessee. And I won't say that. Just picking up some random things here tonight. They're just kind of in one ear and out the other, a little too literally. And now they're both ears, you know. So we would, yes, let me, where was I? Hold on a second. Hold that thought. Don't drift. Stay with me. Wait for it. Drive all night. Up to Bean Blossom, Indiana, home of the Brown County Jamboree. And it was on the morning that we... pay no mind to the man behind the mirrors. All right. Thank you. My thought exactly. Once I saw Danny Kaye entertained for 40 minutes because a moth flew into the spotlight. And when a moth flies into the spotlight, you have to pay attention to it. And so Danny Kaye got into a dialogue with a moth who did nothing but flutter around in the spotlight. It was a beautiful moment. And it's affected me. I'm easily distracted. Have mercy. So... keep saying those things that they don't sound like what you mean, I don't think. Yeah. And the Bluegrass Breakdown lived up to its name, and we were stranded on the highway in Horse Caves, Kentucky. And there's some folks from Horse Caves, Kentucky here tonight, and I'd like to say howdy y'all. Howdy! They don't live in horse caves, but don't do this to me. I'll stand outside the broke down bus, and here comes Bill Monroe up, and he says, thank you. much, folks. All right, our time's about up. We're going to end off with a little number here. I used to be in a band called No and In the Way. Yeah. Okay, this is one that a certain Mr. Garcia said, hey man, you ought to play this for the new riders of the Purple Sage, so I did.
We're better off in bed. Don't you be searching all them Jones downtown when you got Panama already.